The human body is electrical and magnetic in nature. And what we know is that every organ in our body creates an electrical field and a magnetic field. This is the stuff that connects our world. The best science of our time is now telling us that when we create emotions in our hearts, that those emotions actually regulate the electrical and the magnetic field throughout the rest of the body. The brain regulates the signals, but the brain can only do so when it receives the signal itself from the heart. Every day, we create a signal from our heart, and the quality of that signal from our heart to our brain regulates the way the rest of our body functions. So when we feel the feelings of well-being and peace, for example, that is one kind of signal, and it tells our brain that we live in a safe world, and our brain doesn't have to worry about fight or flight or defense. So our brain is able in that time to release the chemistry that supports life and the strong immune system and growth. When we feel a sense of fear and that we're threatened, the brain shuts down that part of our experience for a high immune system and high immune response, and it goes into what is called fight or flight with the chemistry, high levels of cortisol and adrenaline for the fight or flight. It's all about the way we feel in our hearts. Now, this is really interesting to me because when we study those ancient traditions, what we begin to understand is the reason this connection is not acknowledged in the modern world is because the very texts that tell us about the power of the human heart are the texts that were either edited or deleted from our most cherished traditions. And now that they're being rediscovered, we now know how this relationship works, and science is bearing it out. One of the first ways that scientists began to understand that the heart has a memory, and this is very interesting to me, was there was a successful heart transplant from a young child into the body of a woman who was in her 80s. The operation was successful. The woman woke up. The doctor said, "How do you feel?" She says, "I feel good and I'm hungry." He says, "Okay, we'll get you some food." And she goes, "Well, I want not the hospital food." And she began to give very specific kinds of foods that she was craving as she was awakening from the anesthesia. She'd never eaten these foods before in her life. And a little investigation showed that the 13-year-old boy whose heart she had received, what she was craving were the foods that were his favorite foods. They said, okay, maybe it's a coincidence, anecdotally. This led to a series of studies, and they found that this happens actually very frequently, that when an organ is specifically a heart, transplanted into the body of a recipient, the recipient will begin to take on characteristics, such as food cravings, of the person that the heart originally, the body, the heart originally resided in. This went so far, and this is why authorities now are so certain that this memory actually happens. There was a young woman who was murdered, and her heart was not injured in the murder, and it was transplanted into the body of another woman who immediately began having nightmares, the same nightmare, night after night, again and again, very detailed, very specific, very precise about the murder that had actually taken her life. The authorities began to take this seriously into consideration, and they researched the details, and the details were so specific they led to the arrest and the conviction of the person who committed the murder. And when we see that kind of information, it begins to take it out of the realm of anecdote and into the realm of telling us there's a phenomenon that's happening here that we haven't acknowledged in the past. There is a neural network, a brain within the heart. The brain has memory. It goes much more than that. The brain bypasses the logic of the mind. And in this way, it serves us because it can help us make decisions based on what we feel as truth rather than what we judge or discern even. What our bias, our fear, may prevent us from seeing when we think about the choices. Our heart doesn't see any of that because it makes its decisions based upon what it's feeling here, not what we're thinking from our past experience. So the term that now is being coined is called heart intelligence, and it's through this heart intelligence that we're beginning to open a new door of possibility about how this can serve us in our lives in the new world that's emerging, where we find ourselves interconnected with one another and with all life in ways that we're only beginning to understand.